Hello everyone, let's analyze this cycloid. This is the diagram of a particle moving on the periphery, which is the wheel is rolling here. So you can see the path of this particle, red dot here. It is called as cycloid, and this disc is in pure rolling. So let's see the translational motion of the disc. You can see here the point P is having only velocity in x direction, and this is constant here, V naught. Let's analyze the omega part also in this. You can see now omega has come, and these velocity vectors are changing their directions here. You can see, I'll show you effect of omega alone. Omega, you can see for this particle that r omega velocity is only along the tangent. All right, when we combine these two, this is how these two components keeps changing their directions. And you can see when this red dot comes at the lowermost point, its velocity becomes zero. These two parts cancel each other. And when they are in topmost point, they add together, which gives you 2r omega or 2v naught. Let's analyze resultant wise velocity of this. Can you see it? At topmost point, it is more, and at lowermost point, it becomes zero. So that is the condition of no slipping on the surface. I hope you can visualize this particle in a proper manner. Now I'll give you more idea about this cycloid and its radius of curvature. The radius of curvature of a point on the periphery of the rolling wheel. So any point which is lying on this trajectory, its radius of curvature is given by, we can use the standard formula, 1 plus dy by dx whole square to the power 3 by 2 divided by d2y by dx square. When we calculate, it was easier in this format. From this vertical line at an angle of theta at this particular point, if radius of curvature is r naught at this angle theta, then that is given by 4r cos theta by 2. So guys, I'll suggest you to remember this result. It may be very helpful in certain situations. And this is a very common result. In one complete rotation of wheel, the distance traveled by the point on the periphery of the wheel is 8r. So distance between here to here, this is 2 pi r, whereas this distance traveled by the particle is going to be 8r. And this is the parametric equation we can write here. You can say this is a rolling wheel, and this is the situation at t equal to 0. I'm assuming this point is at the lowermost point at t equal to 0. And after some time here, you can see when this rotates by an angle of beta, I can write omega t. So beta is v naught by r into t. So the new xy coordinates here, and I'm assuming origin at this particular point. So you will find here at this point, this is the remaining x distance, so which is v naught t minus this distance, which is r sine beta. So that will become our x coordinate. So v naught t minus r sine beta. So we can say v naught t minus r sine v naught t by r. And this similarly y coordinate I can write r minus r cos beta. This distance I have to write. So it is r minus r cos beta. Here we are going to get r minus r cos v naught t by r. All right. So this is the velocity of point P. By differentiating, we can write, or directly from the velocity diagram we can use. And distance covered in one revolution, I'm not solving it here. So you can just check. If you do that, integral 0 to 2 pi r by v naught, root of vx square plus vy square, this is the speed of P. dt, that is going to give us 4r. So students, please do that problem and do these calculations. It will give you some more confidence in remembering these results. Basically, this, if you check these equations carefully, I'll just show you something here. If you look at these equations carefully here, x and y, so if I adjust these equation slightly and square and add them, so you will be getting here x minus v naught t whole square plus, and here you will be getting plus y minus r whole square, and that is equal to r square. Sin square and cos square term will give you 1. So you will get a very interesting result about this cycloid. Cycloid is nothing but a point where this particle is moving in a circle and the center is translating along the axis of it, and you can see x coordinates keeps changing. So flat circle is its center is changing, so that point comes something like this. All right, so I hope you have understood this concept. It's quite fascinating curve, and that's it in this video. Thank you.